Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 175, and here I am going to discuss how to determine the oxidation number and what is oxidation number. So it is having two type of oxidation number. One is direct, and that direct oxidation number means where simultaneously oxidation reduction is taking place, means at one place the electron is lost and other place the electron is gained. So loss and gain of electron is taking place, that is called redox process, and that is taking place in your electrochemical reactions. And the second one, that is in covalent bonded, because that is in ionic bonds. In covalent bonded, it is on the basis of oxidation number, where the oxidation number is increasing. On that ground, we can say that the oxidation is going on. Now there are some points I will be discussing. The oxidation numbers are given, for example, in many cases like hydrogen it is plus 1, oxygen -2, then metal, alkali metals it is your +1, then alkaline earth metals it is all +2, so +1, +2, but in some special circumstances they can increase into, it depends upon the loss and gain of the electrons in the case of peroxide, in the case of superoxide, in the case of hydride. So those I have given here in a very simple way. So here, the redox reactions are of two types. Number one is, that is called direct redox reaction, when the chemical reactions is carried out, then one of the species may lose electrons, and at the same time the other may gain those electrons. I have already told you, the one species is losing electron, the other species is already there to gain the electrons. This concept of electron transfer can easily be explained, that is called redox reactions in the case of ionic substance, is in the case of ionic, where ions are produced positive or negative, that is cation and anion, in battery reactions. Then indirect redox reaction, for covalent compounds we use a new term, that is called oxidation number, to explain the oxidation and reduction or redox reaction. I have already told you that oxidation we can also give in terms of increasing of oxidation number. If the number of positive charges are going on increasing, 1, 2, 3, 4 positive, it means the oxidation is taking place. And if the oxidation number is going on decreasing, it means the reduction is taking place. And these two, oxidation reduction together, is called redox process. So it is called a redox reaction or process. Then what is oxidation number? The oxidation number is residual charge, positive or it may be negative. An atom appears to possess in a molecule when shared electrons are counted towards more electronegative atoms. So now I am giving some rules of oxidation number. The first rule is, the oxidation number of all elements in their elemental state, uncombined state, is all zero. Oxidation number only starts by transfer of electron, by gain or loss of electrons. Number two, For hydrogen, oxidation number is given as plus 1, except in ions where it is always minus 1. Number 3. Oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2 in general. In general term, it is most of the time oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2, except that in most of the its compound, except that plus 2 in OF, and that is when fluorine is combined with oxygen. Here it will be minus 1. In peroxide, it will be minus half. In superoxide, that is in superoxide KO2. Then number 4, oxidation number of fluorine is always minus 1. Oxidation number of alkaline metals in all their compounds is always plus 1. And that of alkaline earth elements in their compounds is always plus 2. So here number 6, the algebraic sum of the oxidation numbers of all atoms in a neutral molecule is always 0. Number 7, in polyatomic ion, the algebraic sum of oxidation number of all the atoms is equal to the net charge on the ions. Number 7 is the oxidation number of atoms of diatomic, triatomic molecules like H2, O2, O3, etc. is always 0. And here I am giving some oxidation number of carbon in the different compounds. It will give you the clear picture. So in different compounds like methane, then monochloromethane, dichloromethane, trichloromethane, tetrachloromethane, and then sucrose. So here, one carbon, and in the case of sucrose, it is 12 carbon. So in first case, the oxidation number of carbon will be 4 minus, and second case, that is monochloromethane, the oxidation number of carbon here will be minus 2, and then CH2, Cl2, dichloromethane, the oxidation number of carbon will be 0, plus 2, minus 2, it will be 0. Then number 4, in chloroform, that is trichloromethane, the oxidation number of carbon is plus 2, and in carbon tetrachloride or tetrachloromethane, the oxidation number of carbon is plus 4. And here, in C12, H22, O11, here, anything is multiplied with by 0, it will be 0. So it will be 0. And that is actually, I used to say always, 0 is having very special and unique status. If anything you want to finish, multiply by 0. So even if your 100,000 or 1,000 or 1 million will become 0 once it is multiplied by 0. So 0 is a very difficult number. And I call it very unique property. It can destroy, it can multiply, and it can give lot of variables. It's really unique. That's why here, any number, once it is multiplied, it is 0. So with this, thank you very much.